Hi guys, in this video you're going to learn how to quickly create your own branded watermark for your YouTube channel using my favourite design tool, Canva. After that, I'll show you how to upload that little watermark to YouTube and then select when to display it during your videos. If you've not been here before, I'm Nicky Pasquier. I'm a Canva certified creative and I am passionate about helping small businesses like you succeed online using some of the best marketing tips, tricks and tools. So why should you bother watching this video? Because a branded watermark will be totally unique to you and will help you stand out on YouTube. But most importantly, it will add rocket fuel to your channel growth by increasing the rate visitors hit that subscribe button. So let's make a start by heading over to Canva. So we are going to start off in Canva and I'm going to create a design. So I'm going to click on this button here and I'm going to custom a size and enter 800 pixels by 800 and create new design. YouTube recommends that you actually use a template which is at least 150 pixels square. I tend to use templates which are much bigger than needed because when uploaded they'll be resized and they'll look much sharper. So I'm going to show you how to create a couple of different style watermarks, starting with a more traditional look. So starting on my template here, I'm going to select the background and I'm going to change the colour to, let's say, my secondary brand colour, which is this one. I'm then going to go over to the sidebar and click on text and I'm going to type subscribe. I'm just doing this really roughly for now, I'll edit it in a minute. Then I'm going to go over to the elements tab and I'm going to look up YouTube and I'm going to add one of these YouTube icons right here. Okay, now I'm going to just increase the size here by pulling on one of the corner buttons. And I'm going to assume that my brand colours are this lovely teal colour and black. So I'm going to change this to black. I'm now going to edit the text by making it bold. I'm going to increase the size. And then I'm going to space out the lettering a little bit more by going up to the spacing tool right here, clicking on it once. And I'm just going to drag this button here along the letter slide bar just to space out the lettering a little bit. Okay. Now you'll want to use your own brand font here. I've used my own Cooper Hewitt font here, but you'll want to use your own brand font for that. My tip to you is to make sure that you use a font which is clear and bold, so that it really stands out when you upload it to YouTube. You don't want to be using a script font because it just won't read clearly when you upload it to YouTube. Okay, so that's all I'm going to do for now. I'm going to download it as a PNG file, download it to my laptop. Now I'm going to hop over to my YouTube channel. And what you need to do is you need to go up to your icon here and click on it and select YouTube Studio, and that's where we're going to do all our editing in YouTube Studio. You're going to go to the left-hand side menu and you're going to scroll down until you find customization. You want to click customization and you'll see at the top of the page we've got three tabs, layout, branding and basic info, and we're going to click on the branding tab and then scroll down until we find video watermark. And I'm just going to get rid of this that I've got at the minute. Okay, so now we need to upload our Canva file that we just downloaded. So we're going to click on this hyperlink here that says upload and we're going to find it in our local folders. Okay, here it is on my screen. You can see actually you can resize your watermark logo right here by clicking on one of the corner arrows and resizing it, but I don't need to do it because it's already perfectly sized. So I'm just going to click on done. And I don't know if you can see, it's right there in the bottom right hand corner, and that's exactly how it will appear on my YouTube videos. And the last thing you need to do is you need to tell YouTube when you want this watermark to appear on your videos. You can choose one of three options at the end of your video. You can create a custom start time or you want to add it to the entire video. And I really strongly recommend that you select this option here. You want it displaying throughout your entire videos. Okay, and then all you need to do now is go to the top right-hand corner of your screen and click on Publish. So if I go to my channel now, I'll be able to see what it looks like in my videos and see if it's worked. Fingers crossed. Just click over to one of my videos, go to my latest video, and let's see what it looks like. And there it is right there, right in the bottom right-hand corner. And you can see what happens when you hover your mouse over the subscribe watermark. A clickable subscribe button appears right next to it, which your YouTube visitors can click on to subscribe to your channel. Right, now we're going to go back to Canva. And I'm going to show you one more alternative, which is definitely more unusual and a lot more eye-catching. So I'm going to add page and get rid of this teal background. Next, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use my logo, my business logo. So I'm going to find that in my folder, my logos folder. Here it is. And I'm going to just click on it once to bring it up onto my template. I'm just going to enlarge it slightly. And to make sure that it's centrally located on my template, I'm going to go up to the position tab right here and click on it and then select center and middle. Okay, and that's perfectly centered on my template now. Actually, I might make that a little bit smaller. Okay, right, next I'm going to add my text in exactly the same way as I did last time. I'm going to go over to the text tab in the sidebar and click on it. Move that to the top. And now I'm going to choose one of my brand font. Just increase the size slightly. And I'm going to type subscribe. I'm going to make that bigger. Okay. And I'm going to do exactly the same. I'm going to space out the letters using the spacing tab. Just space them out a little bit more. I think I'll also make them bold. And this is the fun part. A few days ago, Canva launched curved text. So I'm now going to click on the Effects tab and select Curve. And you can see what happens here. The text has curved over my logo, but the curve isn't quite right just yet. It's a little bit too steep. So I'm just going to go down to the slider bar at the bottom here. I'm going to grab a hold of this button here and I'm going to reduce the curve slightly. This is incredibly easy to do, but if you'd like step-by-step instructions, be sure to watch my tutorial. I'll leave the link in the end screen and in the description below so you can watch it afterwards. So I'm just going to reduce the curve so that the text sits beautifully over my logo. I think that's about right. Just click away. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to duplicate this text by going right up to the top right-hand corner of my toolbar, clicking on duplicate. I'm going to drag the text underneath my logo, and now what I'm going to do is click back on Effects and I'm going to invert this curve just a little bit more. Yeah, I think that's about right. Just reposition the text slightly. Yeah, that's absolutely perfect. Fabulous. And now I think I'm going to change the color of my text to one of my brand colors. Do the same for that one as well. Excellent. So I'm going to download this image now as a PNG file, as we did before, but I'm going to make sure that the background is transparent. And this feature is Canva Pro only, but if you keep watching, I've got a very special deal for you. So I'm just going to click on download now. I've gone back into YouTube and I'm going to get rid of this watermark here, which we've already uploaded. And I'm going to find that new watermark, which I've just downloaded. And there it is. Again, I can resize it if I want to, but it's the correct size already. So I'm just going to click on done. And there it is. And now I have a very unique circular branded watermark. I'm going to finish that up by clicking on publish. And I'm going to check it out on my channel. And I think you've got to agree that this is a very eye-catching and unique YouTube branded watermark. And that is all there is to creating your own branding watermark. Be sure to draw attention to it either at the start or end of videos. by asking visitors to click on it to subscribe to your channel. I mentioned during this video that downloading an image file with a transparent background is a Canva Pro feature. If you've not already done so, why not sign up to an exclusive 45-day free upgrade to Canva Pro using my affiliate link, which I'll leave in the description box below. If you enjoyed this video, please feel free to share it with your friends and give me a thumbs up, because it really does help my channel to grow. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time.